make a call from 2 hours 50. I hope you remember me. Well, to be very honest, it was indeed a beautiful trip. And when it comes to the worst experience, so technically and emotionally both are legit. So technically, this show, 2 hours 50, being a daily show, as compared to my very first show, which we used to shoot in advance. Okay, this was not the same. So here, the timelines were very something which needed to be taken care of by everyone. As an actor also, we were supposed to understand the value of time. So for me, that show being the very first show, as a budding actor, I understand that how quick things need to be in terms of your performance, in terms of delivering your lines, your scenes really well. So here you have to be very quick with your lines. You have to be ready with your dialogue. For the same, we do a rehearsal together. So during that time, you have a good opportunity to bond with your co-actors, okay? To learn from them how they are doing, how they are able to showcase their stuff, how they are using their acting skills, and a lot of other things that necessarily you won't be able to learn on your own or be confident about. Okay, I know. It's a gradual process. Actors, it's always a gradual process. You have to be always open to feedback, suggestions, criticisms, everything put together. So I should definitely mention about Rahil ji when we are talking about the veteran actors. I mean, it was so sure that Rahil ji was the ultimate fun element, although being the most senior actor in our whole cast, and definitely carrying a very big responsibility of the negative lead in the show, because all his plans and motives and everything that he was doing was having an impact on the show. But behind the scenes, he was such a fun person to work with. And let me tell you, he's a great mimic. He does awesome mimicry of most of the people who are working with him. Because again, as an actor, he has very sharp observational skills. So considering that, I believe he was able to pick up these nuances of all the actors on the set, especially those who used to be a little quirky and weird. I won't name who all those were. I was not one of them, so I'm relieved, because he really used to respect me as a person and used to admire me at times, which was definitely very encouraging and motivating for me, because I used to travel from a great distance to reach my set and my food location. So yes, as I was telling you, that Rahil ji definitely he really used to bring that joyful moments on the set when we all used to be in our own world of being on phone. Most of the actors happen to be on phone while they are behind the camera. Is not on. I mean, it's their choice, but so he used to literally make the atmosphere brighter with his mimicry, with his joke, or with his leg pulling tactics, you know, with some actors, of course, who were great younger than. So it was definitely a fun experience for such a veteran actor. But at the same time, for me, I used to really observe how much he used to get into the skin of the character. So when I think of Gauri ji as one of the veteran actors, senior actors that he got a chance to work with, I got the chance to work with the whole cast. It was a good experience, although we did not have so many things together, or many things in the first place. Yeah. To choose separately, as was the Jannat family that was having their things separately. But whenever she was involved and a part of some scenes wherein I used to be there too. So it was a really good experience because she is definitely a focused actor, and she definitely justified her role considering her body language, her acting skills, and everything put together. And let me tell you, as a person, I felt she is someone who really takes very good care of herself. And this is something also as an actor and a person who should learn, like, how you need to carry yourself, yes, how poised you need to be. And again, she did her job really well. She pulled off her character the most successful way that any actor should have done. So that was something good to know about and observe, learn from as a person. With more presence, we could definitely see that. So that was my experience with these two senior actors.
Yes, there have been some moments as such that are worth being cherished, since Suhasini is really special to me, and it is my very first show which was available for people to view across the globe, and that is how it gave me the kind of recognition that I would really be thankful for, to God and to all those people who thought of me to portray Kyra, to bring Kyra, to life, yes, in that whole story. So starting from day one, I believe there was this whole cast meeting that happened at a producer's office. Okay. Although it was not on the shooting day as such, meeting as such. But that particular meeting brought most of our important directors, actors together. And that was a very, exciting feeling. And, it really made me feel so special that I was chosen to be a part of that whole cast and team of two articles. So starting with that particular meeting at the producer's office in his cabin, and going to this particular scene and episode wherein there was Puneet's wedding in the show. Okay, the wedding sequence that started. And I guess that whole sequence took us almost a week's time. Wherein we were decked up, although it was not easy. So during those 7-8 days, I believe, we used to continuously keep wearing the same outfit mostly, unless there was an immediate change, which used to be, there were different, days, celebrations. Like first, initially we had mehendi, and then we had haldi, and then shadi, etc., reception. So those particular sequences of events in the story then were quite exciting, because there was dancing, there was fun, there was everybody on the set, the entire cast as such. The dancing part and all of that was really, really something that made us feel full of excitement, and we really, I personally look forward to the dancing part. Although we danced like junglies, and except for Ahan, because of course he was, he stole the show. He was a treat to everybody's eyes, and his potential was totally used in that show. And I felt he was really lucky to have got selected for this particular role. So yeah, and then there was another episode wherein we got to shoot outdoor. Okay. And this was for one of the performances of Ahaan. So he had to somehow earn money, somehow meet that target. So for that particular episode, although it was shot very close by where I stayed, but regardless of that fact, the constant interaction we used to get, since there were people coming up to us, you know, especially those who used to watch our show. So that was something which cannot be forgotten. Talk about myself. I was really happy to interact with people who used to see us on screen and how they felt about our show, how they felt about our characters, our look, everything put together. So that was a good experience and a memorable one. Then there was this Ahaan and Pankti's engagement. Got to dance on Nach Dene Sare.
Yes.
I enjoyed that, although I was really nervous because I have a different perception of learning dancing. I cannot learn dance with 5, 6, 7, 8. So I was just observing my co-actors. I was observing the choreographer. But eventually when the, you know, the camera rolled, I danced as much as I could remember. I was like, okay, edit mein ho jayega, koi baat nahi. It really took advantage of that dance sequence because it was fun. And I always find the opportunities to fulfill my wish to dance, which I don't get usually. And on screen, so of course, it's a cherry on the cake because you have such an elaborate set, which is beautiful, so marvelously, so beautifully, and you're wearing such fabulous outfits, everything. So it gives an altogether different feeling. Again, one of the very most important experiences and memories I would really cherish and do hold important for me is fans like you who used to visit our set out of the blue and gift us these beautiful, token of love and appreciation in whatever way you wanted to. So I really loved those particular moments when we used to have so many fans. I would definitely, whenever, you know, I would plan this special very first live session on my Instagram, I'm definitely going to make a list of all the fans who have visited our set. And, I would definitely thank them personally. Not that I did not do this before. But yes, it does matter a lot for most of us as actors. And for me personally, it definitely gives you that boost. It boosts your confidence. It gives you that push to perform well, to perform better, to be confident about how people are thinking about your role. Okay, because sometimes you feel, okay, you are not the lead, but, how it must be. But it's nothing as such because you get so much of love and appreciation. So it does matter a lot. So those particular moments definitely hold a lot of importance and are something to be cherished always. And then coming directly to the ending of our show, which was really emotional. And it was a major setback for all our two Aashiqui fans across the globe. But I must say that these things are not in our hands. We cannot do anything about it. So all we could do was to, keep our fans entertained as long as we were there, with as many episodes we could turn out. All those, from small kids to even the grown-up adults who used to watch our show, with every little feedback they had for us, for every appreciation, for every gesture of love they wanted to show, and they showed, no doubt about it. So many fan clubs, so so many fan clubs, so much of, you know, what you can say. I don't even have words. You know, so many things, you know, our fans and followers used to come up with. And it's really surreal. It's out of this world experience. So it does make you feel like how much your show was close to the hearts of all our audiences. So that was how it was. I'm here on Femezo. So please like, subscribe, comment, and share.